joining me. I'm really happy to be here with you. I know it's been a crazy time, so I'm just looking forward to moving our bodies together. And with that, let's get started in child's pose. So go ahead, take your knees wide and your big toes together to touch and just settle in. So knowing that we're not in our studio in our home space right now, that there might be some different noises, some different feelings running through us, and just bring your attention right into your body. So take a nice deep breath in and use the exhale to land here. Maybe crawling your fingers a little bit more forward. Lengthening out the inhale. And lengthening out the exhale. Maybe rocking your forehead side to side on the mat. Just feeling into the way your body feels today. So go ahead and rock our hands over to the right hand side of your mat. Maybe bringing the left hand on top and anchoring that left hip back in space. Back through center, taking that right hand on top of the left, anchoring down through that right armpit. And dropping into your breath, coming back through center, reaching just a little bit more forward. Spreading out through the fingers. Taking one more big breath here. And as you exhale, pressing up onto hands and knees, finding a nice tabletop position. Anchoring down through the hands, take a big breath in. And use the exhale to round in. Inhale, let the belly sink down, chest up, chin up. And exhale, round. This is a great time to close your eyes and take whatever movement feels like a good idea to you right now. Maybe taking the hips back in some circles. Dropping into your body and the way you feel today. If you're doing something to one side, go ahead and do it to the other. Give yourself maybe three more rounds. Last one, full breath in, full breath out. Find your way back to that neutral spine. Walk your hands out just a little bit. Tuck the toes, find downward facing dog. You can walk it out, pedaling the legs right and left. Pulling the belly in, really finding some length in your spine. Letting everything be heavy. Go ahead and walk your hands back to the back of your mat and find ragdoll. Give yourself a generous bend in your knees. Lay your belly and your chest right on your thighs. Go ahead and let your head go. Maybe shake it out, yes. Maybe shake it out, no. Maybe finding your way to that line with the hands, tucking one finger into your opposite elbow creases. Maybe swaying. Maybe being still. yourself back out to high plank. Firming in here. Finding broad collarbones, nice strong legs, hip points up towards the ribs as you breathe. Find some length in your neck. Keep pulling your belly in and up as you exhale. One more breath in. Downward facing dog. Inhale up high on your toes. And then tiptoe your way forward to the front of your mat, maybe keeping your legs straight just as long as you can. Inhale to lift halfway up. Exhale, bow. Inhale, rise. Roll up, reach up, eyes up. And exhale, fold. Inhale, half. Exhale, bow. Root to rise. Roll up, reach up, eyes up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, half. Bow deep. Rise and fold. Lift half. Step back to high plank. Right away, firming in. Long neck. Big breath in. Drop knees, chest, chin. Inhale forward, baby cobra. Press back through child's pose. Find downward facing dog. Take a breath in. A breath out. Inhale forward to high plank. Hold here. Gaze forward. Exhale, low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Just two choices as we flow today. You can always change your mind. You can always hold plank. Just do whatever works for you in your body, in your space. Inhale high on the toes, bend the knees, gaze forward, feet to hands. Half, bow. Inhale, rise. Exhale, fold. Lift half, flow through. Just riding the wave of your breath. In, out, prepare, gaze, travel, half, bow, rise, fold, half, flow. In, out. High on toes, gaze forward, go. Feet to hands, half, bow, rise, fold. Lift half and flow. Right leg rises, step forward, warrior one. Inhale here. Shoulders down the back. Take that right hip back in space and squeeze in through the left seat. Tailbone down, shoulders down. Gaze firm. Really drop in. Big breath. Hands to mat, flow. Left leg rises, step forward, warrior one. Inhale. And then drop in on your exhale. So right hip forward, left hip back, belly in. Big breath in. Hands to mat, flow. Downward facing dog. Inhale high. Bend the knees. Step or hop if you're ready. Lift half. Fold in. Chair pose. Weight is back. Toes are free. Belly and tailbone down. And then take the eyes up, maybe to the place where the ceiling and the wall meet. Squeeze your thighs together. Peel your chest back, keep pulling the shoulders down. Reach with the arms. Sink lower than you want to. And choose to stay with your breath. Big breath in. Exhale, fold. Half and flow. Right leg rises, step forward, warrior one. Inhale, exhale, sink lower, reach up, flow through. Left leg rises, step forward, inhale, warrior one. Exhale, drop in, reach up, flow through. Breath in, breath out, toes, gaze, go. Half, bow, chair, fold. Half, flow. Right leg, warrior one. In, flow. Left leg, step, rise, flow. Downward facing dog. One breath in, one breath out. Inhale, prepare. Bend the knees, feet to hands. Half, bow. Chair, one breath in. Exhale, fold. Half, flow. Right leg, warrior one. Inhale, rise. Exhale, warrior two. Staying nice and low in those hips, pulling your low belly in to center yourself over your legs. Belly hugs in and up. Squeeze your fingertips. Feel your triceps engage. Flip your front palm. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, flow. Left leg, step forward, warrior one. Inhale, warrior two on the exhale. Outside edge of the back foot, press it down nice and hard. Low in the front leg. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your fingers. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, flow. Downward facing dog. We'll do one more sun bee. Inhale, prepare. Bend the knees, feet to hands. Half, bow. Chair, fold. Half, flow. Right leg, warrior one. Inhale, exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, flow. Left leg, step forward. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, warrior two.
downward facing dog. Breath in. Breath out. Right leg rises. Step forward, warrior one. Inhale the arms up. And then take them down but high in the back. Interlacing the fingers. Open up through your chest. And humble your warrior. Bringing that right shoulder down inside the right knee. You can use a strap here if that works. If you can't get your palms together to touch, that's totally okay. Look back at your left big toe. Rinsing through the shoulders. Release the arms, warrior one, warrior two. Inhale, reverse, hands to mat, flow. Left leg, step forward, warrior one. Inhale, rise. Interlace those hands the other way, behind your back. Really open up through your heart, open up through your chest, and then humble your warrior. See if you can't bring your shoulders away from your ears. And keep pulling your belly away from your left thigh. Smooth the breath. Drop the gaze. Squeeze the shoulders. Release the bind. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, the warrior two. Reverse. And flow. Downward facing dog. Toe heel your feet together to touch. Sweep your right leg back and up. Find your open bend and stretch. See if you can't anchor down through your left heel. And pull that left hip back in space while pushing your chest towards your thigh. If you flipped, which you guys know you can do, come back here. Straighten the right leg long, bring knee to nose. Inhale, sweep. Take it to the right elbow, across to the left. Inhale, sweep. Knee to nose. Take it up. Right elbow. Left elbow. Sweep high. Step forward, crescent warrior. Inhale. Shoulders down. Belly in, eyes up. Straighter than straight in that left leg. Begin to take that left arm down, right arm up. Squeeze your inner thighs. Take your gaze up. Nice and low in those hips. Option to move onto outside edges of the legs. And drop in. See if you can't use your core to pull some weight out of that left wrist. Take one more breath here, and then make your way to side plank. Rainbowing up through the hips, hips forward, hips stack. Reach up, reach out, big breath, flow through. Toe heel those feet together to touch. Left leg, open, bend, and stretch. Okay, option to stay here sinking heavy through that right heel, trying to find some length in the right side waist. Big breath in. Flip yourself over if you flipped. Extend the left leg long. Bring knee to nose. Reach up. Take it to the left elbow across to the right. Sweep up to the nose. Sweep up. Left elbow across to the right. Sweep up. Step forward, crescent warrior. Right, get steady and stable. And then you rise. Shoulders down, heart up. Really strong in that right leg, high on the ball of the foot. Begin to make your way to your twist. Stacking those shoulders, heart up. And stay here for a couple breaths. Right, the left side's always tricky. Because we sort of know where we're going. And if you wish to make your way onto the outside edges of your feet, do so. But try to use your core to pull yourself out of your wrist, especially if it's starting to get tired. Start to make your way to side plank. Right, let it be messy, it's okay. Hips forward, rainbowing up through those hips. You guys are doing great. Stick with it. Big breath in. Option to flow. Press yourselves back. Downward facing dog. Three breaths here. Inhale to toes. Bend the knees, step hop or float. Lift half. Bow deep. Sink the seat, chair. Bringing hands to the heart. Take a full breath in, and then use your exhale to twist. Seat low, belly in. Taking that seat lower than the heart. Finding this twist. Weight back, maybe wiggle your toes. Take one more breath here and exhale, bow. Separate your feet about 6 inches apart. Use your first and second finger to pick up your big toes. Lift half and then bow deep. Elbows nice and wide. Rippling your spine down your thighs with every exhale. And just finding a little space of active recovery. Maybe shaking the head out yes and no. Mind, toe, heel, feet together to touch. Lift half. Bow. Chair. Hands come to the heart. Big breath in. Exhale, you twist. Right, whichever way you didn't go before, taking the weight back on the heels, pressing the palms together, or maybe you open your arms. Squeezing your outer hips in, squeezing your inner thighs together. inhale right onto the palms of your hands for gorilla pose. Inhale and lift halfway up. And then exhale, bow deep. Elbows can come wide. And keep pulling that belly in to support the stretch in your low back. Pick just one point to look at. And really see what you're seeing. Taking a nice big breath in and a big breath out. Sweep the right leg up. Step it forward. Crescent warrior. Inhale, rise. Shoulders down and back. Bringing hands to the heart. Take a full breath in. Pivot the upper body. And then find your twist here. Keeping the hands together. Right, squeezing inner thighs. Pull the belly up off that right thigh. Get light in your back leg. Take a big breath in. Step forward. Prayer twist. Right, weight back. Belly in. Peel that left thigh up. Nice and slow. Step back to that. And twist. Right, working the core, working the thighs. Give it one more breath here. And then open yourself up, warrior two. Inhale to reverse. Extended side angle. Right, and then you've got options here. You can work the half bind. You can work a full bind. You have space for that. Stay low in your hips. Keep some integrity in your core. Go ahead and release your bind. Get really raw through your wingspan here. Take a big breath in. And then float your left hand down, finding your way to lizard pose. Right? And you can rock around here just a little bit, just feeling into those hips. Stay up on your toes like you're staying in a plank. So if you drop that back knee, see if you can't come back here now. And then we're going to pull our right foot up off the floor. Choose to stay for three, two, one. Sweep that right leg back and up. And then you're going to step it back behind your left foot. Walk your hands to the back of your mat. Really fold in. Walk your hands over to the left. Walk your hands over to the right. Be in this fold in the center. Right, in a place that feels good to you. Give it one more breath in. And then keep your legs crossed. Walk your hands back out to plank. So find yourself in this firm plank here. Broad through the chest, neck is nice and long, belly is hugged in. Hold. Give it one more breath in. You can uncross those legs, low plank, upward facing dog, downward facing dog. Left leg rises. You step it forward, crescent warrior. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, brings the hands before the heart, and you make your way to this twist. Squeeze those inner thighs. Deepen the breath. Get nice and light on that back foot. Anchor into your front heel. Step forward, prayer twist. Broaden across the collarbones. Pull your belly in. Peel your right foot up towards the seat. Nice and slow, step it back. Land here. Take a big breath in. And then open yourself up, warrior two. Inhale to reverse. Extended side angle. Right, and then you've got options. You can turn your right palm back, place it at the small of your back, maybe into the crease of the thigh for a half bind. If you have space for it, you can reach around for the full bind. Right, shoulder blades together, gaze up. Hips low, heart up. Go ahead and release the bind. Get broad from fingertip to fingertip. And then float your right hand down to this lizard pose. Right, squeezing everything nice and tight. Long neck. Right, you can wiggle it around a little bit. And from here, we're just gonna lift up our left leg. Right, just holding in. Hold for three, hold for two, and one. Send that left leg back, and then try to get your baby pinky toes to touch, and we're gonna walk to the back of the mat for this fold. This time, walking hands over to the right. And then maybe hands over to the left. Walking back out to that plank pose, keeping the legs crossed if you can. Always the option to come to your knees. Long neck. Keep breathing. Keep holding. You guys are doing great. You're so strong. And then cross those legs, low plank, upward facing dog, downward facing dog. Big breath in, big breath out. One more just like that. Breath in, breath out. Right leg comes back and up. Step forward, crescent warrior. Inhale, rise. Open up, warrior two. Straighten that front leg. Begin to make your way to triangle pose. Hips forward. Look wherever's comfortable with your neck. Maybe take that left arm over the left ear. Getting that nice stretch in the side body. Go ahead and bend into your right leg. Take the gaze down. We're going to come into half moon. Flexing hard through that left foot, pressing down through the right. Maybe taking the right hand over the heart. One more breath in, and then bow deep. Bend into that left leg, take the right leg up, standing splits, or standing up. See if you can point your right toes to your left ankle. Maybe find your balance. Maybe do handstand hops if that calls to you in this moment. Take one more breath in. Take that leg up a little higher. And then bow, big toes together to touch. Inhale, half. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise. Exhale, bow. Lift half. And flow through. Left leg on the inhale, steps forward, crescent warrior. Inhale. Open warrior two. Straighten through that leg. Begin to make your way to triangle pose. Hips forward, heart up. Press down hard through the outside edge of your right leg. Maybe take that right arm over the ear. Getting that stretch in the side body. Keep breathing. Begin to take the gaze down. Bend into that left leg. Squeeze the right leg straight and strong. Half moon. Right, and it's okay if it's messy and wobbly, right? We all are sometimes, especially right now. Okay, so be gracious with yourself. Right, be thankful you're moving your body. Maybe bring that left hand before the heart. Fold as you're ready. Bending into that right knee. Sweep that left leg back and up. Standing split, standing out. Maybe balance on the hands or on the foot. Big breath in and fold in. Lift half. Bow. Rise. And fold. Lift half. And flow through your vinyasa. Making your way to downward facing dog. Taking a moment to reset, to spread those fingers out nice and Take one more breath in. We're gonna drop the knees and come down into heart melting pose. So hips are gonna stay right over the knees. You're gonna reach your arms forward. Maybe take your chin forward if you have space for that. We're just finding a back bend in the upper part of the back. Right, really settling in here. Maybe playing around with the distance between the hands. Walk yourself up, standing right up onto your knees for camel pose. Taking the hands to the low back, begin to push your hips forward, squeeze your elbows together, and start to go back. Right, and if you have space for it, maybe you reach for the heels. Hips forward, heart up. Make your way up. Go ahead and sit down, knees and feet together. Let your eyes close and just feel what you feel. Get really long in your spine. Go ahead and press yourself up. Camel second set. Separate the feet about 6 inches, knees about 6 inches apart. Hands to the low back. Push the hips forward. Heart up. Belly in. Maybe you reach for those heels. Hips forward. Gonna make your way up. Child's pose. Downward facing dog. Pedal it out if you wish. Inhale high on your toes. Bend the knees, step, hop, or float to a seat. Go ahead and lie down on your back, getting set up for bridge pose. We're going to start with a few bridge rolls. So inhale to bring the hips up. And exhale to roll down. In. And out. Do three more. Holding at the top of your third. Just keep moving. And you're more than welcome to take this in a supported position. Coming on up to that bridge pose. Bringing the hands back down to the floor. Maybe rocking onto the shoulders. Maybe taking the bind. Squeeze your thighs. Bring your chest back towards your chin. Pull your belly in. Push down into everything that's touching the floor. Take your hips up just a little more. And then lower down. Take two breaths here. In and out. Inhale to prepare. Bridge or wheel. Hips come up. Whatever works for you right now. Just firming in, anchoring down into everything that's touching the mat, letting our hips come up, letting our hearts open. keep breathing. And then choose to step for 3, 2, and 1. Come down. Take 2 breaths here. We're going to come up just one more time. Bridge or wheel. Set your hands, set your feet, and up you go. Whatever you're working today, right? Know that it might not be perfect, but this is a practice, not a perfect. And wherever you are is the right place. So pull your belly in, open through your heart, right? And then breathe. Choose to stay here. Deepen the breath when things get hard. Squeeze the thighs, parallel the feet for 3, 2, and 1. Tuck the chin, lower down. Find Supta Baddha Konasana. Soles of the feet together, knees open wide. One hand to the heart. One hand to the belly. And then breathe into your belly. Shine away from the shallow breaths of the chest. Using your breath to calm your heart, to refocus your mind, and to come back to where you are right now, right in your body. In your breath. Gently use your hands, gather your knees, give yourself a little squeeze, maybe rock side to side. Just let it feel good. A massage, maybe take a few circles with the knees, give one direction, and maybe around to the other. And then as you're ready, happy laughing baby. Anchoring down through those shoulder blades, pulling down on the feet, pressing back with the feet against the ceiling. And keep that little sway side to side. Or welcome to straighten one leg and then the other. And really opening up through your hips, pulling your low belly down, rolling the tailbone away from you. Try to get your whole spine flat on the floor. Go ahead and release that. Hugging the knees in, and go ahead and change your grip to behind the thighs. We're going to do just a little bit of core work. So begin to rock and roll. We're going to land in boat pose. So flexing the feet, you have the option to stay here with the hands behind the thighs. If that feels good to you, you can also release the arms. Keep your heart up. Maybe take your palms up. Maybe you take straight legs. Right? Know you're right where you're supposed to be. And it's okay if this is hard. Keep hugging your belly in, taking the shoulders down and back. Keep breathing. Deep breath in. We're in a rock and roll. I'm just going to scooch back just a little. Okay? Maybe give yourself 5 big rocks. And then see if you can't land here. And maybe this time right away you release the hands. Maybe you straighten the legs out. But if it causes you to round in, come back to those bent knees. Right? If you feel it in your hip flexors, come back to those bent knees. Right, be in a place where this pose works for you and you're not trying to work so hard for the pose, right? Let happen what's supposed to happen today. And then breathe. I know it's hard, my belly is shaking, and I'm right here with you. Right, so proud chest, hug in, you're doing great. One more breath in, and then we're gonna rock and roll. Right, one more time. I know you guys can, I know you've got this in you. So come on, hold up this time. We're gonna do some low boats and high boats. So open it, and close with the exhale. We're gonna do five. Four. And five. Last one. You've got this. Open up low boat. Hollow body hold for five. Four. Three. Two. One. Hug it in. Nice work. We've got just a minute or so to go upside down. If you have a wall nearby, you're welcome to use it. If you have a pillow, you can place it underneath your sacrum. Just taking the legs up in the air. You can let your eyes close. If you've got a yoga block, you can use that as well. Just letting the heart rate settle. Using this inversion as a warm up for your Savasana. So go ahead and deepen into that breath. Chosen something active, come into something a little bit more restorative. Giving yourself 10 breaths here. With your breath. Again, fold your legs down. If you're up on a pillow or a block, go ahead and remove it and hug your knees in. Go ahead and let your knees come off to the right. Open up the arms. You look off to the those knees back through center, giving yourself a hug in the middle, and then just change sides. Any twist that works for you. Looking off over your right shoulder. Thank you. your arms up overhead, reaching your heels forward and your arms up, maybe making fists and flexing and pointing the toes, engaging all your muscles just one more time. Take a big breath in and release it out. Savasana. If you need one more cleansing breath, go ahead and take it now. And then work yourself into your stillness. Relaxing the skin of your forehead so it's nice and smooth. And the space behind the eyes. Relaxing the bridge of your nose, the corners of your eyes. Just letting everything be soft. Letting your tongue fall away from the roof of your mouth. Unclenching your jaw. Letting your shoulder blades slide down the back. Getting nice and long in your neck. Maybe tucking your chin just a little bit. Bringing some attention to the space around your heart. Maybe noticing your heart beating in that space for the first time today. Begin to take a few deeper breaths. Maybe just a little gentle movement in your fingers and your toes. And as you're ready, reaching everything long and rolling onto a side that's comfortable for you. Using your arm as a pillow, just taking a loose fetal position. Once you're ready, just press yourself up to a final seat. Grounding down through your sit bones, taking your hands before the heart. Just tucking your chin slightly as a motion of gratitude for all the things that are going well in our lives right now. With that thought of gratitude in mind, take a breath in, sigh it out. Bringing thumb knuckles to forehead center. It was so nice to be here with you guys today, even though it's virtual. I love you guys. I miss you. The light in me shines the light in each and every one of you. Namaste, sweet yogis.